the rabbi referred to me children for their problems of development, some of them Down syndrome children. And I must say, they believe that people with genetic disorders, chromosomal disorders, can be turned into high functioning and close, very close to study, to Yiddishkeit, etc. I heard it very much from the rabbi. It was a daring thing, because at this time, people didn't believe it's possible.
When my daughter Zlata Esther was born in 1961, autism was totally unknown at the time. When she was born, I was overjoyed. She was a beautiful, beautiful full-term baby. However, by the time she was 18 months old, she was sitting and crawling, and she looked like a very happy, content baby. She wasn't walking yet, and I was a little bit concerned. So I went in for a neurological test. And the neurological test was inconclusive, but they categorized her and defined her as autistic. I was bewildered because I had no idea what autism was all about. My pediatrician knew nothing about it.
Children or individuals who have, you know, mental or a combination of physical and mental impairment weren't being institutionalized. They were just being warehoused, with custodial care. So I corresponded with Rabbi Schneerson. I said, how may we view this issue from a Jewish perspective?
So I remember coming to his office, and the Rebbe motioned for me to sit her down on a chair. The Rebbe let me voice my concerns, what was going on. And then he took out of his desk a sheet of paper and a pencil and pushed it across the desk towards Lati. And she automatically, without giving it any second thought, picked up the pencil and started scribbling on the paper. And the Rebbe had this big, big, broad smile on his face. He was absolutely delighted. And he said, "Ich weiß nicht, was mir macht der ganze Meister da." Gave me some suggestions what to do. One of them was to place her in a regular kindergarten or nursery school in the neighborhood. And then he told me to go see Dr. Schick. I think the Rebbe felt I could do a lot with this child. And that gave me the courage to teach her a lot of things and make her quite independent.
What he was saying very clearly again and again and again is that we, even for the most severely impaired, that you have to have expectations for improvement.
This is a group of special children that we teach. We all meet on Sundays and we learn Yiddish kind of rabbis. Can you give them a bracha?
Can you just listen to special? Look out for all the group, and then we want to send them this to charity, on this home, on this money.
It is important that the trainees themselves should be encouraged, both by word and the manner of their training, to feel confident that they are not, God forbid, cases. Care should be taken not to exaggerate expectations through far-fetched promises. However, a way can surely be found to avoid raising false hopes, yet giving guarded encouragement.
Well-meaning people told my wife to take Yossi out of the house because blind, deaf, hyperactive, trying to raise a family of young children was pretty much impossible. You couldn't put a glass on the table, you couldn't put a vase on the table, everything was plastic. You had to protect Yossi against himself, other children from Yossi in terms of his rambunctiousness, and he was full of energy. And at night she would cry and say, "Ribbono shel Olam, God, I'll never take Yossi out of the house, but if you ever decide to help my Yossi, I will dedicate my life to helping other mothers who are struggling with their children with disabilities." We came to New York looking for medical help. My uncle, Dr. Herschel Samuels, talks to me about having an interesting new patient, Mrs. Schneerson, very bright woman. I said, "Uncle Herschel, are you talking about Mrs. Schneerson as in the Lubavitcher Rebbe's wife?" said, yes. I said, you know, Uncle Herschel, if you could get me a blessing from the Rebbe, it would mean the world to me. While we were standing with the Rebbe, Yossi was running around, you couldn't control him, and the Rebbe kept giving him nickels, and Yossi would run two steps, three steps, and throw away the nickel. And the Rebbe would give him another one, and he'd do the same thing, and we were dying, we were so embarrassed. And the Rebbe said, lost him. This is a gesunte Tchuna, leave the child. This is a healthy quality. I really can't go into the Rebbe's mind, and we didn't ask what his intent was. But in seeing what developed, his tenacity, that just like he took the nickel from the Rebbe, you know what? Boom, another one and another one, and that's it. Yossi has never stopped, and hopefully he'll never stop.
In English, das ist Autistic. Das ist zurückgeblieben. Er ist 22, er wird bald 23 Jahre. Er ist in England in spezielle Institution in London. Ein jüdisches Institut. Wir haben ihn nicht gebracht, kein Amerika. Aber davon eine Woche, man muss sie einfach schreiben.
Just him validating that she had possibilities. That gave me tremendous hope. And if you have the hope and you have a special child, you can do ever so much more.
Every possible emphasis should be placed on the tangible and audio-visual aspects of Jewish education in terms of the actual practice of mitzvahs. It would give him a sense of belonging and attachment. Even a subconscious feeling of inner security would pass into the conscious state, especially if the teacher will endeavor to cultivate and fortify this feeling.
Interessant, dass ich habe einmal probiert mit dem Lernen sozusagen eine Woche und das ist schon gesucht.
Ja, gesucht.
Und auch bekannt für sie bei ihm, das war sehr hart, dass er bekannt ist.
Er hat das so gekriegt, was ich im Sinne.
Nein.
Sie konnte doch
heranstellen.
Das ist eine Sache, was er hat, aber mit Jess, und das war mein halbes Verwendung, dann noch schafft, ich kann ihn dann besuchen. Das ist der Mann, den wir uns besuchen, dann haben wir mit Abdeckung
zu. Ja, ist okay.
Nothing ever stopped Yossi. Not then, not later. At the age of 20, he lost his ability to walk. Today, he's 43. He wanted to ride elephants in Thailand. He rode elephants in Thailand. He has an amazing sense of smell. He wanted to learn to be a sommelier, a wine professional. His wines, called Yossi, went on sale in Israel. Yossi has never given up, and I believe, in retrospect, that was the quality that Eva was talking about.
Our understanding of the other is very much affected and related to our understanding of ourselves. In the way the rabbi understood the condition of the individual, and the way he claimed and suggested and felt empowered to say, yes, do it, there was a very different way of seeing the human being. Not as a just reflection of yourself, but as something which comes, the Ara, the Leila.